All right, guys, we're looking at defending elbows in this video. And one of the best things that I found worked for me, it was actually taught to me in Silat, this one, having the two options of either the same side or cross side. I'm going to break that down for you in a second. But this actually worked for me well sparring in Thailand, in Muay Thai. I had a guy that was a lot taller than me. He's professionally fighting, and we were sparring. And believe it or not, he was taller. He's a lot taller, a lot fitter, younger. And he's coming down with these elbows and doing this sort of thing. And one thing I found that worked for me, if I could just have an elbow, please, like this, coming over the top and getting in on his guard. So the point that we want to make with this is, to stop an elbow, you need a really solid structure, as we were talking about before. You mentioned that that fight. Who was the two guys before? You just showed me a video.
Yeah, Matt Brown and Diego Sanchez. One of the worst knockouts I've ever seen. He's got his leg up, he posts on his face, and just comes down across the back of his head. And Diego has his hands up. It's not like he's not defending himself. The elbow just cuts right through it into the back of the head, and it's fucking out. He's out.
Yeah, it's fucking horrible. So, I mean, in situations like that, yeah, it's as I mentioned in the last video of how to actually put in the elbow in a fight, it can be very defenseless, as in hard to defend. And to be honest with you, a lot of times, as I said in the other video, when I've used it, it's always been from here or that sort of thing. But if it's coming from a guy that does like Muay Thai, it might come like this, or a lot more sort of postured and coming down, easier to read. And even then, it's not easy to deal with. But you want a cross structure. So we do look at the vertical, horizontal, diagonals like that. And we go through them all technique for technique on our online learning and in our actual classes and everything. So if you want to check that out, check that out. But for this, what we're going to introduce is the concept of either same side here or cross side here. Okay, now you can see my guard is cutting through his guard there, especially as he's taller. Now if that ends up just going over and rolling through, cool, I'm right there. Or I can use this bottom hand, if it's there, and come over the top, grab his head. I might headbutt her, or if this is in the way, because he's a big fucker and he lifts, I'm gonna put that down on there, you know. So my objective here is, if it's coming this way in a sort of horizontal and or diagonal fashion, I want to try and meet that however it may be to make a cross. So if it's, as I said, horizontal, you'd go vertical if you can read that, and that's why we train, so we can read an oncoming attack, be here. And then I can either go underneath like so, like I said, you can roll this through, or I can either come underneath like this, and I've got the face, I've got the head, I can do all these ones, you know, we'll shove him, create distance, and obviously fuck off as soon as I possibly can. The other one, so the cross hand. So say, for example, I'm walking with my kid or whatever the fuck, you know, you've got your girlfriend with you, your missus or your side chick or whatever you want, whatever the fuck, right? You're like, oh fuck. And at that point, if something was to come, that it might not be as likely, but that's the point. This hand's busy, right? You come down and wham. And that was the last one I used, as I mentioned, in Thailand, that worked really good for me. Because this young fella was, he had some fucking skills, you know? So my point is that when I'm here, when I've got that, you tap down, and then wham. But if you don't have a proper structure here, when you meet this, it's just gonna come through and land on your face. So, you know, I think everyone's like myself, allergic to shots in the face. And I just wanna put it that way, see if we get a reaction out of him. But but yeah, basically you've got underneath, which is the same side, right? Same side as in where you're looking at, it's coming from the same side, or cross side like this, you've got on top, and that's the two methods that we use. We break them down with the angles. There's a few adjustments, a few things to be aware of, and how you actually set up these drills so that they're realistic and functional. As I was saying to Ian before, only time I've seen guys get elbowed, I was telling you about a situation where we had to ask some bikers to leave, and one guy bumped into him on the way out. One of these noms, actually, we call them noms, the nominees, they're our prospects. Not that I'm involved with them, but we had to deal with them a lot, and it was all sweet. But one guy bumped into a nom, and he just grabbed him and went like that, and it was just short, sharp, little fucking elbows like this. And the guy on each elbow just started to like stagger down and just fell in a heap of shit, you know, and just like fuck. For scenarios like that, obviously it's a lot harder to deal with, and that's why you need those skills of being able to not let someone in your personal space, you know, and just be situationally aware and also have spatial awareness. So that's how you would avoid and prevent such things. But at the end of the day, you're trying to train to cover as many scenarios as you possibly can, and then have the heightened sense of awareness and logic and discretion to be able to deal with people when it comes to that point at hand. So I hope that makes sense. Hope that's helped you out in understanding what your realistic options are. And if you want to know more, definitely check out our online learning, subscribe, and share this video. Cheers.